Welcome to Commerce class. In today's class, we shall see the difference between new issue market and secondary market. What is the difference between both? Okay. First, we'll see what is the meaning. A marketplace for new share is called primary market. Now, with regard to this, I will give you one small example. If Mr. Ramu, purchase his share directly from Reliance, let us say Reliance company is issuing shares. So if Mr. Ramu purchased the share from Reliance company, then that is called new share and that is called a primary market. Okay, so he purchased directly from the company. So that is called the primary market and that is a new issue of shares by the company to the investor Mr. Ramu. Now, if Mr. Ramu wants to sell the share, he can sell it. So, he can sell it to anyone. So, if he sells it to another person, maybe let us say his friend, Mr. Vinod. Okay. So, when he sells it to his friend, then that is called as a secondary market. So, let me tell you, when the shares are purchased from the company by Mr. Ramu, then that is a primary issue and that is called the primary market. And when Mr. Ramu sells it to his friend again or maybe to someone else, then that is called the secondary market. And there is no place as such called primary marketplace where you can get only the new issue shares. There is no physical place or no building or no existence like that. But secondary market, we can say that a stock exchange, for example, is a place where you can buy the shares or debentures or any securities that were issued in the new issue market. Okay. Second difference, buying. You have to buy directly from the company. Okay. So that is direct. Here they say indirect because now, Ramu bought it directly from the Reliance company. So, direct. When Ramu sells it to his friend, this is indirect. Because we know this getting the shares of Mr. Ramu, which Ramu invested in the companies. Next, financing. It supply fund to budding enterprises. So, very new enterprises which are just started. Or it can be even for the existing company if they want to go for expansion or some diversification. So the reason for financing can be anything. Okay, so the company might require a fund to start a new project or to expand or to diversify its business, or it can be for an enterprise also. So, financing, the reason is this. Here, it does not provide funding to company. Now, the same example, because Mr. Ramu sells it to Mr. Vinod. So, the dealing is between Ramu and Vinod only. It is not between Vinod and the Reliance company. Let me make you clear. Okay. So, the dealing is between Ramu and Vinod. So, the amount of the transaction takes place between Ramu and Vinod only. So what Ramu bought from Reliance company, he is selling the security to Mr. Vinod. Clear? Next, how can securities be sold? How many times? Only once. So the primary market security can be sold only once. Here multiple times. Why they say multiple time? Now the same example. Ramu, when he sells to Vinod, now Vinod also can sell it to anyone who demands a higher price for the security. So it keeps on changing hands like that. So that is why they say multiple time. Here only once, because Mr. Ramu bought it from the Reliance company for the first time. After that, he sold it to Vinod. So here it can be sold only once in the primary market, whereas in the secondary market, the security can be sold many times. So next, buying and selling between. Here it is between the company and the investor. Here the investor was Mr. Ramu. Here, investors, many hands I told you. Now, when Ramu sells it to Vinod, Vinod may sell it to any other person. So, the investors are many in number. Gained person, who is one who is benefited. Here, the company is benefited because direct investment, whatever amount they required, they got it from the investor, Mr. Ramu. Here, who is benefited? The investors are benefited. Each and every time, when the value of the security keep rising and when the security keeps changing hands, the investors are benefited in the amount of price difference. Now let us say when Ramu bought the security, that is a share, it must have been, let us say that the face value is rupees 100, but when he sells it to his friend Vinod, maybe it can rise up to 150, let us assume. Now when Vinod sells it once again to another person, it may go up to 200 also. So here the gain person are the investors, but first initial issue, the gained person is the company. Next, intermediary. Who is the one who is in between? Here it is the underwriters. Underwriters, they may be some organization or person who takes the risk of issuing the securities. So that they are called as underwriters. They may be bankers also. So underwriters, they are the one who are in between the company as well as the investors. Okay, here the brokers are the intermediary. Price is fixed. The face value of the shares is fixed. Here it fluctuates, keeps on changing depending upon the demand and supply of the financial asset. The price for the financial asset, that is the securities, keeps changing, that is fluctuating. Organizational difference, not rooted to any specific spot or geographical location. I told you this point beginning itself. There is no particular place where you can buy new issue shares. Any company which issues the shares for the first time for any reason, it can be for diversification or expansion or venturing into a new project, for any reason, if they issue shares, then there is no place where you can say that if I go to this particular place, I can get that shares of this company. No, nothing like that. So no, not rooted to any specific spot or geographical location. Okay, but here it has physical existence. It has got a building, it has got a place where you can buy the second-hand securities. Okay, so that is one example, is a stock exchange. So let us just recall here, the meaning is where new issue shares are issued, that is called the initial issue market. Here resale market, because what is issued in the primary market, those securities are traded here, so you call that as a secondary market. Buying is direct and here it is indirect. Reason, financing, maybe budding enterprise, new enterprises, or maybe the existing company for the purpose of expansion and diversification. Here does not provide fund to companies. Issues, how many times? It can issue only once. Here multiple times it can be bought and sold. Who is selling? Buying and selling. The company is selling and the investors are the buyers. Here it is only the investors. Gained person are the company. Here the investors, the underwriters, one who undertakes the risk of issuing the security. Here the brokers. Price is fixed, fluctuate depending upon demand and supply. No specific place where you can get the securities. Here it has physical existence. Thank you, children. Now let us go on to the next one. Here we'll see the classification of financial asset. There are two types of asset: marketable asset and non-marketable asset. Here, marketable asset means that can be marketed, that is, that can be sold from one person to another without any difficulty, that is called marketable asset. So what can be sold like that? Shares of listed companies, Listed company means companies whose names are listed for the purpose of trading. If in a stock exchange one particular shares or debentures are bought and sold, then that particular company's name must be listed in the stock exchange. So that is why they say listed companies. So shares of listed companies, government securities, bonds of public sector undertaking, all these are marketable assets. Okay, it can change hand from one person to another depending upon the demand and supply. But there are some assets which are called as non-marketable asset because you cannot change hand. Like for example, bank deposit, provident fund, pension fund, NS, national saving certificate, insurance policies. This all this cannot change hand. So you call them as non-marketable asset. So what are the classification of asset? Marketable asset, non-marketable. Example for marketable they have given you. Now just this you can to gain more knowledge. What they say, what is a financial asset? It is an asset which is used for production or consumption or for the creation of asset. So a financial asset is that which helps you to create more asset. That is it in simple terms. Here, for example, they say buys equity shares and these shares are financial assets. So if you buy it, it is a financial asset. Then they go on to say, what is the objective of this investment? It is decided on the nature of the asset. Now, if you buy a building and you reside, that is if you buy a house and you stay in that house, there is no financial gain. But if the same house is let out for rent, then you are getting a, then you call that asset as a financial asset. That is the difference. Okay. So with these classifications, we come to the end of the session, end of this lesson also. So what we saw today was difference between new issue market, secondary market, financial assets in the form of marketable asset and non-marketable asset. Thank you, children.